Pennsylvania's top high school and college soccer teams go into action September 1st and 2nd at the annual East-West Soccer Classic. For advanced tickets, call 741-2366. It's your chance to see the state's best teams Friday and Saturday, September 1st and 2nd at Mount Lebanon and Quaker Valley. Call 741-2366 now for tickets. All proceeds benefit the Alzheimer's Association of Pittsburgh.
Okay, now look. We want to look, we want to be a little more decisive with our runs. Number one, again, we got to make some runs sooner and quicker and be decisive with the runs. So when that player out here wide is under pressure, he can make a quick decision and he sees some guys going. Okay? So let's say, Brad, back to me again. All right? So we come here, he knocks it back. Okay? Now, I go to Joe.
Thank you. Our sports show cameras were in the house at Quaker Valley High School as the Quakers hosted the Blackhawk Cougars in the road green. First quarter, Quaker Valley's Joby Glessner left foots it in to give the Quakers a 1-0 lead. Great placement on that shot. Check out the move by Joel Perkovich. Gets up, shoots the rebound. Sam Shamovich buries it. 2-0 Quaker Valley still in the first quarter. Then it's Brad Kristoff showing some speed and a quick shot. 3-0, the Quakers were rolling. QV kept pouring it on. Sam Shamovitz again centers to Craig Madera. His goal gave the Quakers a 7-0 lead. Quaker Valley smoked Blackhawk in this game, 9-0 the final score.
Thank you. Ombe sail, Ombe tell you to row.
Ombe, Ombe,
Ombe say, Ombe de yo.
My grandpa, he's 95, and he keeps on dancing, he's still alive. My grandma, she's 92, she loves to dance and sing some too. I don't know, but I've been told if you keep on dancing, you'll never grow old. Come on, darling, put a pretty dress on, we're gonna go out tonight. Dance all night long. I'm a hard-working man, I'm a son of a gun. I've been working all week in the noonday sun. The woods in the kitchen and the cows in the barn, I'm all cleaned up and my chores are all done. Take my hand and come along, let's go out and have some fun. Come on, darling, put a pretty dress on, we're gonna go out tonight. Dance, dance, dance. Dance, dance, dance. Dance, dance, dance all night long.
Pick on!
Dance, dance, dance.
You know when you smile, I've got to say, you're my honey pumpkin lover, you're my heart's delight. Don't you want to go out tonight? You're such a pretty lady, you're such a sweet girl. When you dance, it brightens up my world. Come on, darling, put a pretty dress on, we're gonna go out tonight.
And dance, dance, dance. Dance, dance, dance. Dance, dance, dance all night long.
Yes, indeed, it's fun time, fun time.
Because you can't, you won't, and you don't stop. Because you can't, you won't, and you don't stop. Oh, when you can't, you won't, and you don't stop.
If you ain't coming back, the show is shining.
I wanna say a little something that's long overdue. The disrespect of women has got to be due. To all the mothers and the sisters and the wives and friends, I wanna offer my love and respect to the end.
Well, you say I'm 20-something, then I shouldn't be slugging, but I'm working harder than ever. And if you call it Mac and someone's home to sit up on the couch and watching my TV's,
yeah.
Listen to wax, I'm not using the CT.
Well, I'm that kid in the corner, I'm all fucked up and I'm
match, it was time for the boys' AA championship game, and once again, it was a rematch of last year's final. The Steel Valley Ironmen were out to defend their title against perennial power, Quaker Valley. Same as the Hunters, this year they would be the Hunted. And the man with the biggest target on his back, Steel Valley's John Strom. The WPIL's leading scorer, Strom, made his presence known early by firing this 30-yard strike to give the Ironmen a 1-0 lead with 4:45 left to play in the first quarter. It looked as though Steel Valley would add another before the end of the quarter, but Quaker Valley's Mike Norris comes up big for the Quakers. Now the fog rolls in and the game becomes a defensive battle. Steel Valley clings to its one-goal lead. Quaker Valley tried desperately to knot it up. The Quakers unloaded shots, but none could find the mark. And like last year, it was Steel Valley hanging on for the WPIL AA championship, 1-0.
Destroys the night, night divides the day. Try to run, try to hide, break on through to the other side. Break on through to the other side. Break on through to the other side, yeah. We try
our pleasures here, dug our treasures there. But can't you still recall the time we cried? Break on through to the other side. Break on through to the other side.
What the situation was, where it was, what were the conditions, you know, we were going to be ready for that or that.
But it takes one sometimes.
Just one more than they have, right?
It was a good one.
How you feeling, Church?
If we win this next game, his hair's coming off.
Yeah, Mike.
John's getting the set.
Hey, guys. How's it feel?
Oh, it feels great.
How's it feel, dude?
It's great.
The Quaker Valley Quakers are the only team from our area to represent us in the state championships at Altoona, and you know our sports show cameras were there to watch what they did. Take it away, guys.
Because of some bad weather, namely snow, the state finals were moved to Mansion Park, Altoona. The change of venue would suit Quaker Valley just fine. The Quakers had made it back to the title game and were looking to do what no other team had ever accomplished, win a fourth state soccer championship. To make a little history, Quaker Valley would have to get by Ole Valley, which donned the white home unis for its first trip to the finals. The team spent the first quarter trying to get used to the AstroTurf field, the frigid temperatures, and each other. And in the second quarter, Quaker Valley finally broke through. Joby Glessner found Chris Tedesco, who hit nothing but net. It was 1-0 Quakers. Quaker Valley turned up the heat in the second half. Less than 2 minutes into the third quarter, the Quakers would add to their lead. Off the inbounds pass, Joby Glessner gets it to Chris Churchill, who got the shot off and scored. 2-0 Quaker Valley. And while the offense was starting to click, the defense was also making big plays, led by goalie Mike Norris. 14 minutes after making it 2-0, the Quakers would strike again. Brad Kristoff to Joel Perkovich, and just like that, it was 3-0. From that point on, it was up to the Quakers' defense and goalie Mike Norris to preserve the win in the shutout. Not a problem, as the Quakers became the first soccer team in state history to win four PIAA titles.